ヤリスがヨーロッパのカーオブザイヤーを受賞しました。今回はトヨタモーターヨーロッパの CEO マットさんに話を聞きます。トロフィーもあるらしいです。
Hello, good morning. Nice to meet you. I'm Morita. Thank you for today.
Nice to meet you, Marita san. I heard a lot about you already.
Thank you.
マットさん、まずヨーロッパのカーオブザイヤー受賞おめでとうございます。
Well, thank you very much. I was confident that we would be in the top three, but I didn't expect to win, of course. So we're very excited, happy, proud, and pleased that we did win. Pleased, I think, particularly for all of the people who worked so hard on the development of Yaris, both here in Europe and in Japan.
その今トップ3に入る自信はあったけど、トップになる自信はそれほどなかった。これどうしてなんでしょうか？
Well, we thought that the new Fiat 500, particularly with a full electric powertrain option, and also VW with the ID.3, were both very strong competitors and, of course, highly supported by their national journalists. Or that's what we expected to happen.
裏を返せば、それだけ競争が激しい中を勝ち抜いてのこのカーオブザイヤーだったということなんですよね。
That's right. I think it was a very impressive shortlist of competitors in terms of strong brands, you know, great models and you know, increasingly electrified technologies. So for Yaris to stand out from that shortlist was an incredible result. Of course, we tried to structure our final presentation to the jury members to really emphasize Yaris's strengths, particularly versus BEVs, where we wanted to demonstrate that, you know, with over 80% of our sales hybrid for Yaris, that it was making a much bigger contribution to reducing emissions than the relatively low numbers of sales of BEV models. And then, of course, with the GR Yaris, we were able to also show a completely different, fun, exciting, emotional side to the vehicle as well. And I think this sort of multi-dimensional approach, together with President Toyota's personal message to the jury members, where he explained his own role in the development of the car, you know, born in WRC, and how much time and effort he'd spent with the WRC drivers inputting to the development of GR Yaris. I think overall we had the most powerful presentation.
私もトヨタ社長の応援メッセージというのを拝見したんですけれども、やっぱりあれは強力な後押しになったんですね。
Oh, definitely. And I think, you know, listening to what the COTI organizing committee told us, I think for him to appear in that message and to address them directly, and for them to see how passionately committed he is to making great products and to delivering such a, you know, high performance product like GR Yaris, really made a huge contribution. It's probably one of the three things that they talked about. Why did Yaris win? This is definitely one. In fact, Marita-san, I wanted to just take the opportunity, because I know you'll move on to other topics, but I actually have here the original trophy. Of course, I couldn't pick it up on the day because it was a virtual ceremony. We were not allowed into the Palexpo in Geneva to meet with the organizers, but it's just arrived here in Brussels. I've kidnapped it and it's in my apartment with me doing quarantine, but then I shall take it and we will send it to TMC, and I'm sure that Akio can have it in his office, but I wanted to share it with you today.
その重みというのはいかがですか?
It's very heavy. It's very heavy. And it comes in its own suitcase. So obviously, as you may know, it's very specially designed to reflect the sort of logos a little bit of the promotional magazines that you know, promote the car of the year, and the design of it is meant to look a little bit like the face of a futuristic vehicle from the front, but it must be, I don't know, it must be something like 5 or 6 kilos. It's very heavy. It's heavier than the Olympic torch, I think.
その重さにはいろんな方の思いとかこれまでの努力っていうのが詰まってるんじゃないですか。
Well, I think that's a great analogy, and I know that with this project particularly, there was a huge amount of effort to really make sure that we developed a car that would be fully competitive and, you know, the best car it could be within the segment. Even so much so that I think back in 2015, there was a very difficult decision taken to delay the timing of the next generation product and to extend the life cycle of the current model. And at the time, that was a very brave decision to make. It looked like it would be the longest life cycle ever in the B segment. It came with maybe a lot of commercial risk. But in hindsight, it was exactly the right decision to make sure that the new Yaris was built on the right platform that could make it a truly competitive car, class-leading car. And that was the right decision. And that's ultimately, I think, why it won. So that was great.
もともとそのトヨタ、それからトヨタが作ってきヨーロッパで売ってきた車、作ってきた車っていうのが抱いていたイメージっていうのが今回のこのヤリスによって変わった、変化した部分っていうのはあるんでしょうか。
Well, I think I would answer as follows. I mean, our image for Toyota in Europe was fairly, I would say, static for maybe 10 years between 2005 to 2015. And since thenIt's really continued to strengthen dramatically. Of course, part of that is definitely about the TNGA platform being rolled out, you know, and exciting new models that we've launched like CHR. Part of it is also about hybrid sales success, which has certainly differentiated us as a brand. And I think also, you know, our success in motorsport,with you know, Gazoo Racing has also created a lot more desire, excitement for the Toyota brand image in Europe. So when you add all of these three things together, our brand image is moving in a very, very positive direction. This award from Coty and the publicity it gets and the fact that we're using that in all of our communications will only furtherhelp us and amplify that new image. And maybe I could also just, in terms of context, confirm. I mean, Yaris is our best-selling model in Europe, and of course, our most produced local model in Europe by far. And in fact, in the first quarter this year, it also became Europe's, Yaris became Europe's best-selling passenger car for the first time ever for a Toyota model. And in fact, the first time ever for a Japanese brand to hold that title. So, you know, Yaris has always had a unique personality and be seen as quite innovative, in addition to having very high safety and, of course, being very accessible and easy to buy and to drive. But because of its weight, I mean, when people think of Toyota in Europe, they think of Yaris, then this award will have so much of an impact in terms of the total brand.Perception of Toyota.
先ほどいくつかこの今回 の, この選ばれた理由の中で挙がった一つに、まず一つずつちょっと聞いていきたいんですけれども、ハイブリッドというところなんですが、その 80% 以上がハイブリッドの車種をお買い求めになっているということなんですが、ヨーロッパにおけるこのハイブリッドっていうのは、今、どういう位置づけなんでしょうか。
I mean, let's say that already if I take year to date, 2021, 55% of our sales as Toyota Lexus in Europe are hybrid. And if we exclude the Eastern markets like Russia, Kazakhstan, Ukraine, which are, of course, not really Europe, just part of our European region, and we focus on Western Europe, then our hybrid sales mix is around 70% of our total sales.So hybrid defines the Toyota brand in Europe. It absolutely makes us unique because we are by far the most dominant player. Of course, in recent years, demand for diesel and trust, particularly in diesel, which was the core powertrain in Europe, has declined a lot. So hybrid almost became the new, I would say, baseline powertrain for...European customers. They trust it because it's proven in terms of its reliability. And there is no compromises in terms of ownership experience or indeed purchase experience in terms of premium. So it, you know, it sells at the same price level as diesel. Its residual value is higher than diesel. You don't need a dedicated infrastructure. You don't have any range issues. You don't need time to charge it.So from a convenience point of view, for customers, it's the perfect solution for right now.
あの日本でいろいろな報道を見ていると、ヨーロッパっていうのは先ほどあのマットさんご自身おっしゃっていたように強力なライバルとしてその EV、 バッテリー EV というようなものがあったりとかですね、こう EV 化が世界の中でも一番進んでいるような印象を受けていて、そうした中でもこうやってハイブリッドが選ばれている、こうした現状っていうのはどう見ていらっしゃるのか、そしてこれはこの先もまだまだ続きそうなんでしょうか。
Well, you're right. Obviously, Europe has very strict CO2 regulations. Those really came into force in terms of financial penalties for 2020 and 2021. And we have seen, because of the lack of demand and trust in diesel from consumers, we've seen many of our competitors have to quickly accelerate plug-in, but also full electric powertrain solutions in order to dramatically reduce CO2 and avoid huge penalties from the regulators. I mean, today, just to put it in context, if we look at year to date, together plug-in plus the battery electric vehicles are probably about 12% of the market. So it's still relatively small, but it's twice what it was 1 year ago. So it's growing very quickly. For plug-ins, it's mostly, I would say, the premium brands, Volvo, BMW, driving the plug-in mix. For the BEVs, it's mostly the volume brands, VW, who of course had a big problem with diesel, Renault, and Stellantis, to avoid financial penalties. And I think, frankly, towards 2025, we will still see continued growth of full electric. But in reality, the conditions are not optimal today for many customers. For example, Yaris, you know, probably around 80% of Yaris drivers, they don't have a driveway to park the car in to be able to recharge the car. They mostly park on the road. So they, you know, the infrastructure is not yet developed well enough to really accept further significant acceleration. But beyond 2025, there is, you know, there is expectation from our side that we see a dramatic acceleration. All of the necessary enablers for speeding up electrification are being put in place. That's more renewable energy capacity, more infrastructure in terms of charging, local battery production, investment in Europe. All of those things are happening, including incentives as part of the EU Green Deal. So in the second half of the decade, we see a big acceleration likely in the zero emission vehicle mix, probably to maybe 40% of the European market by 2030. So we have a lot of opportunity in the next 3 or 4 years, and then we have to speed up a lot in the second half of the decade.
あのやはり規制、国、それからその EU という、まあ、大きい組織にの規制によって後押しされている部分と、一方でお客様の需要というところと比べると、ちょっとそこの2つ両者には今のところまだ乖離があって、結局今お客さんは現実界としてハイブリッドを選んでいる、そんな状況というふうに理解してよろしいんでしょうか。
Yes, I think if you focus on the next 2 or 3 years,I think that's exactly right. Demand for the full electric vehicles is heavily influenced by subsidies and by incentives, rather than, I would say, inherently customers wanting to choose that technology. Because, of course, the battery costs are high, the infrastructure is immature, the renewable energy charging is not yet at the level it needs to be. So it's a little bit early for, I would say,customers to feel that that solution is right for them. Maybe for some, but not for many, many, many customers, which is why we are focused on offering a wide range of electrification choices. You know, hybrid is the best solution for a lot of customers right now. But for those who want full electric only in the city, where maybe there is the infrastructure, we will introduce zero emission options. We have it already in the light commercial vehicles.And then plug in for those who have, let's say, an occasional longer range requirement. So the way I would say, you know, Toyota's strategy is very customer based. you know, we don't have the pressure of the regulatory compliance. We are in good shape. We're even making money out of pooling with some of our alliance partners to help them. And our hybrid strength means we can follow real customer demand, not be forced to impose a technology that maybe customers are not quite ready for, or the you know, the experience that customers have is not quite optimal yet. But in the second half of the decade, you know, if all those investments happen, that demand will shift towards zero emission quite quickly.
日本では去年総理大臣がカーボンニュートラルを目指すという宣言があって、ようやくこう世の中にカーボンニュートラルというのが浸透し始めたのかなという段階なんですけれども、ヨーロッパっていうのはやはりそれよりももっと早くからこのカーボンニュートラルの意識っていうのが一般の方、消費者の方にも浸透しているんですか？
Definitely, it's growing, I think, you know, quite quickly. I think particularly even in the younger generations are becoming extremely environmentally conscious in terms of their decisions and the brands that they want to associate with. So they are looking increasingly as customers to you know, towards automotive manufacturers, in other words, to lead the way, to be pioneering, to be transformative, and to be public in showing their commitment to carbon neutrality. I mean, luckily, Toyota has, ever since the Paris agreement with our 2050 environmental strategy, we've obviously had a very clear point of view on this. But sometimes the global statement of Toyota is not quite enough for Europe. Europe is moving much faster, and we are just seeing in the last year or so, you know, many of the European manufacturers making quite bold statements about the race to zero and how quickly they can achieve that by 2040, not 2050, or by signing up to even, I think, in the case of Polestar, to build the first carbon neutral vehicle by 2030, in terms of redesigning their production processes and their supply chain to deliver something like this as a big advantage. So, of course, we're working very closely with TMC to make sure that we maintain our position as an environmental leader, and that we accelerate, you know, our responsibilities as quickly as we can in this direction.
先ほどの今回ヤリスが選ばれた理由のところとして触れられたモータースポーツのところについて伺いたいんですけれども、やはりこう WRC にヤリスで参戦をしていく中で、ヤリスのイメージっていうのはどんどん変わってきた、そんな感覚っていうのはあるんでしょうか？
Yeah, absolutely. No question about that. The reputation and the awareness of Yaris has been significantly increased by not just participation, but also the success, the dominance almost of Yaris in WRC. I was in Paris in 2016 at the motor show when Akio with Tommy Mäkinen got onto the stage and announced that we would be bringing Yaris, or bringing, you know, returning to WRC, and you know, in 2017. And I think nobody could have believed then that we could become so competitive so quickly and so dominant just as quickly as we did. And it's brought a completely different, exciting, dynamic image to Yaris. And it's allowed us to connect, you know, our retailers and the road cars that we have in our showrooms to our success in racing in a way that we could never do with Formula One, and it's very difficult to do even with the WEC, the Endurance Championships. It's recognizably Yaris, and it shows just how strong the vehicle is. So it's no question, it's a big factor in transforming Yaris' image. And I think GR Yaris has taken that to a completely different level. You know, I had 21 years in this company. I have never seen a reaction to a car like the one we have had for GR Yaris, from the media, from the retailers, and from customers. You know, we thought to sell 9,000 GR Yaris, which is a big part of the global volume, would be a huge task. And by March this year, we were sold out not just for 2021, but for 2022. demand for the car is incredible.
まあ、先ほどからモータースポーツであるとか、まあ、そのハイブリッドのところが評価されたいろいろ要因というのはお話ししてくださったと思うんですが、やはりこう忘れてはならないのは、そういったものを実際に作るだけのものづくりの力っていうのが、やはりこうフランス工場を中心にあったということかと思うんですけれども、そこに対してはマットさんはどういった声をかけられるのか、かけてあげたいのか、いかがでしょうか。
Well, I think, you know, already in the last 12 months, the people in Valenciennes have had a huge challenge, trying to prepare for the start of the production for this, new Yaris, which of course was impacted by, the COVID pandemic. And ever since that situation, because of the delay in the production timing, we've had a number of challenges, as you can imagine. And still today, they are fighting to try to, because demand is much higher than our supply capability. So they are fighting to improve every area of efficiency that they can in order to try to follow the demand level that we have. And remember, just in a couple of months' time, we are due to launch the Yaris Cross in Europe. So the same people in Valenciennes are working very hard to protect the launch timing of the Yaris Cross, and it will be the first time that they have a second model to build in the plant. And it's not just a second model, it's a completely different production mix when you look at the volume of the Yaris Cross versus Yaris, which we will also build in the Czech Republic later this year. So it really is a transformational time in the middle of this pandemic for everybody in Valenciennes. And you know, we count on them very much, because most of our growth plan in the next couple of years is really in the B segment. It's coming from the full year effect of Yaris, plus the breakthrough Yaris Cross, which is of course a very fast growing, exciting segment for us to enter.
そのフランス工場を中心に、ヨーロッパの、トヨタのヨーロッパが持つものづくりの力っていうのはどういうふうに感じていますか？
Well, I think we have great capabilities locally in Europe, and we made a lot of progress in improving our cost competitiveness. Particularly, we've also made a lot of progress in reducing the, you know, the process time and the cost increases associated with the TNGA platform, so that our level of cost post-TNGA is not higher than it was pre-TNGA. But going forward, the challenge with this increased electrification pace in Europe is obviously how to adapt our manufacturing footprint to be ready for 2030, when 40% of the market is zero emission vehicles, and we need to be building locally the zero emission vehicles, then we have a lot of work to do to be ready for that next step in terms of transformation.
今後、トヨタのヨーロッパのトップとして、どのようにこう会社を導いていくというかお考えでしょうか？
I think maybe to mention five quick things. One is growth, because today we're selling just around 1 million vehicles a year in a profitable and in a responsible and sustainable way in terms of also managing CO2 reduction. But as I mentioned, I think with our expanded product range and powertrain range, in the next few years, we have the opportunity to grow our market share. And with some market recovery that's expected, I see that we can increase our sales. I think secondly, electrification, as we've discussed in depth, we need to speed up our transformation to be ready for the second half of the decade, where we will need to be producing locally fully electrified vehicles in order to be competitive and to sustain that level of volume and market share. And that requires us to adapt our not just our manufacturing footprint and supply chain, but also our business model. With our retailers, we need to be able to make money and create new revenue streams that can compensate for some of the ones that we won't have with fully electrified vehicles. So this is a big challenge that we need to do more work on quickly now, not wait until 2025 or beyond. And the three other areas that I'll just touch on, sustainable development, you've already talked about carbon neutral. I believe this is an area where we can truly differentiate ourselves as a brand, because it is really in Toyota's DNA. It has been ever since the company was founded to care about our contribution to society, to take a long-term view and to, you know, to offer the customer solutions that are right for the customer. And I believe that more than any other European manufacturer, we can use this to increase our engagement with and relevance to European consumers. With regards to the other two topics, it's really about mobility and expanding our mobility products and services. We are making huge progress with the scaling of Kinto in Europe and 5 prioritized mobility channels. We have a very clear vision as to how we will use our retailers, how they will become mobility service providers in the future to operate the car sharing and subscription services that we want to offer in the marketplace. And I think we can become a benchmark for global Toyota in how we do that, working very closely with Toyota Financial Services. And finally, in terms of diversity, equality, and inclusion, this is a very important topic. And again, one that I think Europe, because of our geographic diversity and cultural diversity, can really play a leading role in helping guide Toyota globally. You know, to be innovative, we need diverse human resources. And we are doing a lot of great work to embed those principles in our company culture in Europe so that we can accelerate. I think that's an area where I'd like to prioritize it more and see us move even faster to be agile and to be able to make quick decisions and the right decisions in this world of uncertainty that lies ahead. So those are the 5 areas that I'm really excited about and focused on.
Could you show me the trophy again?
There we go.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.